Rocket technology has advanced rapidly over the last 60 years, and in that time, it is estimated that over 35,000 rockets have been sent to space. But with such rapid innovation, you're bound to have some accidents. Space organizations spend years making sure everything is correct. However, a single error can cause those years of work to go down the drain in a matter of seconds. From the United States all the way to China, here are five rocket launches that went horribly wrong. In October of 2014, NASA was set to launch an unmanned Antares rocket off the Virginia coast. The goal was simple: to deliver goods to the International Space Station, something that had been done many, many times before. Unfortunately, things took a different turn that day. When the launch began, it was business as usual, but that didn't last for long. An investigation into why the rocket failed soon followed. A year later, a report came out detailing how there was an explosion within the rocket's liquid oxygen turbopump in one of the two AJ-26 engines. This caused the rocket to lose its thrust and come crashing back so close to the launch pad. The explosion was triggered when stationary and rotating parts within the turbopump came into contact with one another. The excessive amount of friction that was generated led to the ensuing fire. However, the report could not figure out what caused the issue in the turbopump in the first place. Investigators narrowed it down to three potential issues, or perhaps some kind of combination of the three. It's possible the explosion occurred as a result of inadequate design robustness of the engine itself, which made it more susceptible to oxygen fires. It's also possible a debris such as titanium or silica got into the engine. Finally, there could have been a manufacturing defect within the engine. Investigators could not say for certain exactly what caused this disaster. Luckily, no one was harmed in this launch. On July 1st of 2013, a Russian rocket was set to take off. However, things quickly went askew when the rocket began to veer off course. You can see in the video how significantly it's skewing to the side, which can only mean disaster. It didn't take long for the rocket to begin breaking apart before falling back to Earth and exploding. Findings from later found that the failure was likely due to an emergency shutdown of the booster's engines and about 17 seconds into takeoff. Luckily, the rocket was unmanned, but it was carrying 600 tons of highly toxic kerosene, AMYL, and HEPTYL fuel, which were spilled all over the surrounding area. While the fuel did give off a poisonous smoke, it was partly contained thanks to nearby rain at the launch site. Unfortunately, the people of Baikonur, a town about 36 miles away from the launch, were still in harm's way. An alert went out telling them to stay inside with the windows closed until further notice. The rocket was insured for 6 billion rubles, which comes out to about 182 million American dollars. The failure came on the heels of a slew of rocket launch mishaps to occur in Russia. Three satellites were lost in December of 2010 when a different Proton rocket also failed during launch. After this particular incident, all proton rockets had to be grounded for months until a detailed investigation could be carried out to try to prevent future disasters. On January 17, 1997, a rocket that went by GPS-IIR-1 was set to be the first Block IIR GPS satellite to set flight. It was supposed to operate as a component of the United States Air Force Global Positioning System, but it blew apart only 13 seconds after it took off. You can see how quickly things go from exciting to devastating in one humongous blast. The rocket took off from Cape Canaveral. It was found that the rocket's flight termination system was activated via its onboard computer. This detonated the explosive charges located around the rocket, causing it to go up in flames. When it exploded, the rocket was roughly 1,600 feet in the air, making it the lowest altitude explosion to occur at Cape Canaveral since the Atlas Centaur AC-5 disaster in 1965. Later, an investigation found that the failure was due to a crack in the casing of the number 2 solid rocket motor. This crack began to form at T plus 6 seconds, and it only got worse from there. At T plus 12 seconds, the SRB casing finally ruptured, resulting in debris getting stuck at the number 8 SRB right next to it. That led to the motor failing, and at that point, there was no hope of salvaging the mission. A manual destruct command was set to terminate the launch for safety reasons. Residents of the surrounding area were advised to stay inside and keep their windows closed because vapors from the rocket could be toxic or irritating. The impact was still felt in the nearby town. Some damage to store windows were reported as much as 10 miles away from the launch site, but buildings can be repaired. Luckily, nobody was killed from this incident. The Vanguard TV-3 was the United States' first attempt to get a satellite into orbit around the planet. The world saw several successful Soviet launches with Sputnik 1 and 2, so the United States designed the Vanguard TV-3. This was a small satellite made to test the launch abilities of the three-stage Vanguard and study the effects of the Earth's orbit on the vessel. It was also meant to obtain geodetic measurements through the orbit's analysis. The key words in that last sentence are meant to. The launch was set to take place on December 6, 1957. In just 2 seconds after liftoff, the rocket began to lose thrust. It fell back to Earth onto its launch pad. As it settled back onto the ground, the fuel tanks ruptured and subsequently exploded. The rocket was destroyed, and the launch pad sustained extreme damage.
There were a number of failures during the year, and the United States promptly announced them. The first and most spectacular of these was Vanguard at the end of 1957. There were other Vanguard failures. All achieved takeoff, but trouble occurred either in the second or third stages.
An investigation ensued, but they could not determine the precise cause of the accident. It's believed that the fuel system malfunctioned in some way. After the incident, the satellite was too badly damaged to be salvaged. However, it went on to be displayed in the National Air and Space Museum in the Smithsonian. On February 15, 1996, a satellite called INTELSAT 708 was supposed to be launched from the XICHANG Satellite Launch Center in China. However, the satellite itself was built by the American company Space Systems LORAL. You can see the rocket take off, and immediately you know something is wrong, because it's heading in the complete wrong direction. Later in the video, you see the rocket transforming into a fireball before crashing back to the ground.
Hey,
The rocket ended up crashing in a nearby village where 6 people lost their lives, according to a Chinese report. However, estimates that came out of America suggest that the number could be much higher. A video crew later went to the village where many buildings were completely destroyed. An investigation took place afterward, which determined that there was a failure within the rocket's guidance system. The investigation forced the Long March Rock program to greatly improve its reliability. The program did not experience another failure until 2011. However, the parties involved with the disaster did not get out of it unscathed. The investigation led to a huge political controversy in the United States. The US government conducted its own investigation, which found that information from the report had been given illegally to China. Space Systems Laurel had to pay $20 million to settle charges of violating export controls. Rocket launches are necessary to support our modern way of living. However, all the time and money put into them can't always ensure they'll go off without a hitch. All space organizations can do is learn from these mistakes and try to make sure future disasters don't have a chance to happen. Be sure to click the link on screen to check out 5 ship launches that went horribly wrong. As always, thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.